A very warm welcome to all my students and everybody here. I am Dr. Nalini Mishra from Department of Education. Today I am going to deal with the topic identification of teaching skills. In my previous lecture, I had talked about micro teaching. I gave an introduction on that, and this is an extension of my previous lecture. Micro teaching and the teaching skills, these are an important part of the curriculum of BEd. I deal with the topic every year. And I hope this lecture will benefit you when you will go for your teaching practice. First, I will start with what is teaching. We all know that teaching is a science and an art also. When we give teaching a scientific base, we are able to divide the teaching into various components. When we analyze teaching into various components, we come across various teaching skills that are used in a classroom. When a teacher goes in a classroom, he should be equipped with all these teaching skills so that he may manage the class properly and very efficiently. An effective teacher is one who has all these micro teaching skills, and he uses these teaching skills in his regular classroom teaching when and where required. To use these teaching skills, he has to practice it, and to practice it, he has to know what are those teaching skills. So first, in my this lecture, I will tell you about what are those teaching skills that a teacher has to equip himself with. And then in my later on, when I'll have some more lectures, then I will be explaining these teaching skills one by one. The analytical concept of teaching considers teaching as a complex skill which comprises various specific teaching skills. So the teaching skills can be defined as a set of interrelated component teaching behaviors for the realization of specific instructional objectives. When a teacher enters a class, he has some instructional objectives in his mind, and to achieve those objectives, he enters the class. So when he goes into the class, he should be knowing those teaching skills so that he may take the lecture properly, manage the class properly, and can achieve those teaching skills, those teaching behavior outcomes, those instructional objectives effectively. So these teaching skills help him a lot when he has to realize those specific instructional objectives. Now the question arises, what are those specific teaching skills that are associated with this complex set of complex task of teaching? And in how many components or constituents can this complex task of teaching can be divided into or analyzed into? What are those skills that we are describing as teaching skills that lead towards effective and efficient teaching? Many research workers have worked in the field of education, and they have worked on the areas of teacher effectiveness, analysis of teaching, psychology of learning and teaching, observation of teaching, and organization of student teaching, etc. And they have tried to identify several sets of teaching skills. And you may come across those teaching skills with a little bit different name or different terminologies, but they are all same when we read them and when we go into the detail of those teaching skills. We have many teaching skills that we can talk about, but in my this lecture, I will tell you about, introduce you with some very important teaching skills that a teacher cannot do without. Take his lecture very properly or deal with his task of teaching very effectively. There are various stages of teaching. When we talk about teaching, there are various stages of teaching, and the stages of teaching are the planning stage, introductory stage, presentation stage, and the closing stage. In these four stages, we have different teaching skills that a teacher has to use. In the planning stage, there are many teaching skills used, like writing instructional objectives. This is the first teaching skill that is used in the planning stage, writing instructional objectives. This is very important for a teacher. Until and unless a teacher is not writing his instructional objectives properly, he will not be able to work on those objectives, and he will not know in which direction has he to lead his teaching. So writing instructional objectives is very important for a teacher, and this is an important skill. It comes in the planning stage when a teacher has not entered the classroom, when he is in his own space, in his own teaching space, working with himself, and he is planning what he has to teach in the real classroom settings. So writing instructional objectives is very important. Next is selecting the content. When a teacher has written his objectives of entering the class. Now, in the light of those objectives, he has to select the proper content that he will take up in the class, so that what he has thought, what he has framed as objectives, he is able to perform the task properly and achieve those objectives with the help of that content that he will teach in the class. So selecting the content is very important when a teacher is doing his work in the planning stage after writing the objectives. The third skill is organizing the content. When a teacher has selected the content too, but he has to organize it. How will he use this content in his own way, in his in keeping his own interest and the student's interest, and how he will manage the class? He has to think about all this in the planning stage, and he has to organize that content properly. And the fourth skill that is used in this planning stage is selection of the audio-visual aid material. To present the content, he has to use some audio-visual aid also, so that he can perform his task well and effectively deliver the content to the students. The second is introductory stage. This is the second stage of classroom teaching, the introductory stage. After the planning stage, when the teacher enters a classroom, when a teacher who has done all his work, all his he has planned it very well, now he has to go in the real classroom settings. And in this stage, he will introductory stage, in this stage he will introduce the lesson properly in front of the students, so that they may know, okay, what has to be taught in the class. Now, introductory stage, this involves two skills. First one is creating set for introducing the lesson and introducing the lesson. First he has to create a platform, a set where he will go and he will talk to his students about the lesson, and then he has to introduce the lesson. These are very important skills, because when you gain interest of the students in your lecture, in your lesson, they will listen to you very properly. Half of your work is done when the student has taken interest in your lecture. So you'll be able to achieve those goals and aims that you have framed in your minds. So when you create a set and introduce the lesson very properly, they'll be able to understand that lesson, because they'll be taking keen interest in your lesson and your chapter that you are going to deal with. The content that you're presenting, they'll have a very good interest in that, and then they will deal with that very properly. You'll be proving yourself as a very effective teacher if you have introduced the lesson very well. The third stage is presentation stage. In this stage, there are various skills used, like questioning skills, presentation skills, aid use skills, and managerial skills. Questioning skill, which is a very important part of regular classroom teaching, because through this skill you interact with your students with the help of the content that you have framed and planned for them, and you make questions, you ask questions to them. They answer to your, they give responses to your questions, and in this way you interact with your students. You know what they have in their minds, what queries they have in their mind, are they getting your points that you are explaining. So this is a very important skill, questioning skill. It involves structured classroom questions, fluency in questioning, probing questions which are asked from time to time, so that you may know whether the student is taking interest in your teaching, and if he is not able to answer those questions, then what more questions can be asked with. The questions delivery and distribution, which is also a very important part of a regular classroom teaching. How are you distributing your questions among your pupils? Use of higher order questions, divergent questions, response management, the way the students are responding, you have to manage those responses so that you may direct them to the content that you have to teach with. So this is very important. Questioning skill is very important, and I'll be dealing with this skill in my next lectures, so that I can explain to you this thing better. What is this skill all about? This is very important for a very effective and lecture, and a very efficient, to become a very efficient teacher, you need to equip with yourself with this skill very much. The second is presentation skill. In this presentation skill, of course, this is the main part of your lecture when you are presenting your content in front of your students. Presentation skills, you have to pace the lesson, you have to lecture, explain, discuss, demonstrate, illustrate with examples. So this is the main part of your execution part of your regular classroom teaching, where the teacher is very active in front of the students, and very effectively he's trying to explain the content. So this presentation skills, which involves all these structures and modules and these components that I have told, a teacher has to know all these individually, and he has to use when and where they are required. So this is also very important. These skills are very important for a classroom lecture, and this is this skill the teacher has to be very active throughout, and mentally, physically also, when he is using, demonstrating with examples, using some equipments or experimenting in front of students. So he has to be very active in all the ways so that he can have the proper lecture in front of the students. This third skill that is used in the presentation skill is aid use skills, in which he has to use the teaching aids that will help him in his lecture. Use blackboard, stimulus variation, silence and non-verbal cues, and reinforcement. All these are very important, because through these, through this aid use skills and through these components, a teacher can interact with the students very well and have his lecture very properly done in front of the students. He has to reinforce the responses. He has to variation. He has to do the stimulus variation too very properly. Then there comes the managerial skills, in which he has to promote pupil participation, reorganize the attending behavior, and manage the whole class. So these managerial skills are very important for a teacher, because we see the skills that I have told, these all are very important for a teacher, because when he is able to use these skills properly in the class, only then a teacher can have his lecture very effectively done. So at the presentation stage, when the teacher is interacting with the students directly in the class, these skills have to be used very properly. Then comes the closing stage, in which the teacher has to achieve closure, of course, and he has to do all the closing very properly. In this, he has to plan what part of the content he has to repeat with. He has to give assignments in this stage, evaluate the pupil's progress, and diagnose the pupil's learning difficulties, and take some remedial measures to solve those queries. So these are the main teaching skills that I wished I should use, and I should tell you in my this lecture that I have told. I'll be taking these skills one by one in my next lectures that I'll be doing with. And I hope this lecture has given you an introduction of the skills that a teacher has to equip with themselves, and this will be very beneficial for my BEd students. Hope you all do well and in your real classroom settings and real classroom situations. With all these wishes, I close my lecture. Thank you all my dear students, and everybody who watches this lecture.